Freedom, Folk, and Soul, a transformational community of the healing arts.
I believe we were born to love.
We are the ones we've been waiting for. It's time to live our dreams and remember, we were born to love.
Have you ever wondered what you are doing here? Well, the truth is there's a simple explanation. It's written in the starry skies above. Take a look at all of God's creation. We were born to love.
Freedom, Folk, and Soul. Sharing journeys of transformation, firewalks, Native American ceremonies, sacred journeys with cacao, breathwork, concert, and ministerial, Reiki, and healing arts trainings and certification. Leading the Toltec medicine wheel of transformation and power journeys all over the world. Bringing indigenous healing ways to modern, everyday living, a more spiritual, present life of love and personal freedom. Join us. Turn your experience into your wisdom, your pain into your purpose, and your wounds into your medicine.
Hola, mis amigos. This is Stephanie Urbina Jones, and it's wonderful that you have joined me here tonight. I'm really honored and excited to share with you some of the experiences that have been portals to open my heart, to connect me to the messengers of love, to connect me to my ancestors, to connect me to my heart. I'm going to be taking you today on a sacred journey breathwork. My husband and I, with Freedom, Folk, and Soul, a transformational community of the healing arts, are honored to have created this powerful music for you to drop in tonight, today, whenever you choose to join us. I'm going to invite you to take a moment and close your eyes. Take a deep breath. And I'm going to call on the great God of your understanding, of my understanding, the great mystery of life, to all that loves us in this life and beyond this life. We invite you into this moment, into this sacred journey breathwork. Ancestors, allies, friends, family. Again, all that loves us, you are welcome to come and be with us on this sacred journey today. A few years back, I found myself in Mexico, and I had gone there after my abuelita passed from this world to the next. I wanted to connect with my roots. I wanted to remember who I was. And so I found myself in this little town, now one of the most beautiful, renowned cities in the world, San Miguel de Allende. At that time, it was a sleepy little town. And I was there, falling in love with my culture and falling in love with the heart of Mexico. And one day in my Spanish class, I opened up the newspaper that was completely in Spanish. And there, the only thing that was in English, it said a gathering of healers. And I didn't even know what that word was, but I knew I needed to find out. So I followed the directions and I made a phone call. And I found my way out into the country in Mexico to this little abuelita, this little Mexican woman's house. And there was about five or six people. And I hardly could understand what was going on, but one thing I did know was that they were using drums and music. And it was the invitation to breathe and to kind of invite my spirit, my heart, into an altered state of consciousness. And before I knew it, I was breathing and I was seeing things. I was being connected to my grandmother on the other side. I was having visions of my future, and I was feeling things in my heart that were still hurting and that were unresolved. And I was being able to make peace in this short period of time where this music and this drumming was happening. And I did this breathwork journey and came out of it. And at the end of it, I had a vision for my life. Again, my grandmother had told me what I was supposed to do with my life, but I hadn't felt that yet. And so I made a commitment after leaving that breathwork that I would return back to the United States and I would do my best to be courageous and brave and to become a mensajera, a messenger of my culture, and telling the story of midwifing my grandmother from this world to the next, and her talking to the angels, and me not only questioning but believing in miracles and that there is life after death. So that has been now 20 years later, and as many of you know, I'm living my dreams as a recording artist, as a mother, as a wife, as a Toltec transformational teacher. And one of the tools that we use and love the most is this sacred journey breathwork. This music was curated by me and my husband, Jeremy Pajer, my co-founder of Freedom, Folk, and Soul. And it's an invitation. It's an invitation for your heart and for your soul to drop in and to breathe. Big circular breath. Keep breathing. Keep breathing and allow your spirit to take you wherever it wants to go. Just trust whatever your intuition brings to you. If you see a rabbit, follow that rabbit. If you feel, you know, tingling in your hands, or you see things or you hear things, just allow it. The messengers want to connect with us and guide us. So this journey is going to invite you into your heart so that you too can dance with the ancestors. I'm going to invite you to maybe put this on pause. Find yourself a really comfortable place to lay down or sit back in a chair. Put your headphones on and just start listening to the music. Jeremy, my husband, is going to take you on a meditation journey. Just allow yourself to drop into that journey. And then when he says breathe, just go ahead and let yourself breathe really big. All right? And keep breathing until your soul is guided somewhere. You start feeling something. And the music is going to be about an hour set. And just let your soul, as Sting says and sings, let your soul be your pilot. And on the other side of this hour-long journey, we're going to invite you to open your eyes and to come back. We'll do a little drumming and invite you back into the present moment, but bringing all the magic that you just experienced with you. And we're going to put on some music and we're going to invite you to journal. You know, just write what you were feeling, what you were seeing, what you were thinking. You know, just allow your soul to come forward. And I will see you on the other side. I wish you a beautiful journey, and if you need to, you can always reach out to us after this journey if you need support in processing what happened or what you saw or what you felt. Have a wonderful experience, and I'll be there with you on the other side.
So I just want to invite you again to take a slow, deep breath. And feel your body connected to the floor. Connected to the Great Mother. And I want you to imagine that there's a cord extending down deep into the earth and a cord extending up into Father Sky. And Imagine both of these energies are coming together in between our heart and our solar plexus and creating a powerful light that is surrounding us. And using our intention and our will, we set this container as our protective container, that nothing can come into this container that we do not want to come into this container. And what needs to go out will go out and go back down that cord into the mother to be reborn, to be renewed, recharged. So when you feel like you have this in your mind's eye, take a deep breath. And know, letting it go, knowing that it is in place. Now I want you to set your intention for this journey. Whatever that is, to go into our family of origin, to fly with the eagles, talk to our ancestors, to be in relationship with their spirit guides, whatever it is, we encourage you when you have that, you know, we let that, we take a deep breath and we put it out there, and then we let go of the expectation and we trust that our soul knows where we need to go. Like I said earlier, whatever comes up is exactly right. We trust life. You've done that. I encourage you to take that deep breath and let that go. I want to just take a moment to have each of you call in your helpers, guides, spirit keepers, angels, bottom animals, whatever you might need, courage, insight, whatever it is, you ask for. When you feel like you've asked for that, take a deep breath and let that out. And move your attention back into the body. And using your imagination, which is one of the most powerful spiritual tools that we have, and breathing regularly right now, I want you to imagine that you're in a desert, a high desert in Mexico, and the sagebrush there. And there's lots of light browns and yellows. And there's the cactuses. And you've been on a journey. And you're walking through this desert as the initiate. And you've been living and experiencing and learning your whole life to get to this moment, this day, that you get to travel to this amazing epicenter, spiritual epicenter, called Teotihuacan, where a man becomes God. And there's some trepidation, there's some fear, there's unknown. You don't really know what is waiting for you. But you know that you need to go there. So as you walk down the trail, you begin to see the temples on the horizon, and they get bigger and bigger. And they're so big that you've never seen anything so miraculous, so enormous. and the wonder and awe begins to rise in you. And also the hesitation, and fear. And are you ready? Are you ready for this journey? You get closer and closer. Closer and closer. And you look to your right, and there's somebody there, an ally, an ancestor, walking with you. And you make that eye contact. And there's a reassurance. So you continue forward. And up ahead is a gate or an entrance. Very distinguished place in which you enter into this holy city. And so step by step, step by step, you come up to the edge of that gate, and you can't really see the way that the gate's designed, what is beyond. And you turn around and you look at all the places you've been. Know some part of you knows you can turn around and you can continue to be in the places you've been and live the life that you've been, or you can step into this temple and who knows, but you recapitulate your life, good, bad, dark, light, the regrets, the triumphs, and you take a deep breath, and you step up to that threshold, you feel it all, and you know absolutely this is a leap of faith. So I'm going to invite you to begin the breathwork breath, deep circular breathing, and step through that threshold. And to have an amazing journey. And we will see you on the other side.
Thank you.
begin. Go back to this space, this moment. Gathering all of taking your time. You know where to be. There's nothing to do. Just gently allowing yourself to come back into this space. Allow this song to hold us.
Every time you open your mouth, every time you speak, every time you listen to your brother, every time you are weak, every time you talk to the children, every time you wonder why, every time you think you are lost, every time you wanna cry, just hear it, feel it, and know that you're alive, taste it, don't waste it, it's a beautiful. Every time you forgot.
Welcome back, my friends. I hope you had a sacred journey. No matter what happened, I truly believe that your soul was your pilot and that there's no coincidence. I hope that you've taken a few minutes to allow yourself to just kind of express, find words, find colors, find a way to communicate and share with yourself, honor this journey that you just took. I can be completely honest and tell you there have been sacred journey breathworks that I have done that have transformed my life. Something so profound was revealed to me that I felt, that I released, that I saw, that I knew. Saw an ancestor connected with something that happened in my childhood and made peace with it. These ways have been so powerful in dramatically changing my life in the last 10 years. And I'm so deeply honored to walk and share them with you and with others. I want to invite you to take really good care of yourself over the next few days. Keep journaling, keep eating foods that are grounding, keep drinking lots of water, and if you get an opportunity to get a massage or some body work or a hot bath, take really good care of yourself so that you can honor whatever came up and allow it to integrate into who you are. I want to thank you truly from the bottom of my heart for allowing me and my husband, co-founder of Freedom Folk and Soul, Jeremy Pajer, to share this sacred journey with you. It truly is a great passion of ours to have the privilege of being present with others as they find their truth, as they find their passion, as they heal and become more of who they were born to be. If you ever want to look anything up and join us, you can check us out at freedomfolkandsoul.org. We're always leading journeys around the world and sharing our hearts with people who are ready to transform their lives. Again, my name is Stephanie Urbina Jones. Some folks know me as Shaman Heart. Muchísimas gracias. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for letting me be a part of this sacred journey with you. Adios, mis amigos.